Folks, welcome back to the Bobby Bo Show. Got a good game for you here. Here's the moves it starts with. Playing d4 as usual, and they're playing the Indian game, knight to f6. I'm going to play c4, taking the center, getting ready to develop my pieces, and bring the knight out to c3. This is my typical opening, the bishop to g5 to pin the knight to the queen. How you guys like my chess wraps? More coming soon. Make sure you're subscribed. Hit the like button if you like the wraps so I know. And they bring their bishop out to b4 to pin my knight to the king. And I like to trade these pawns here in the middle to open up the c-file. I'm going to put my rook here, usually, and take advantage of that. And now I bring the other knight out to defend the bishop and get ready to castle, maybe. And this is something I don't see usually, the queen coming up for some reason, instead of developing their other knight or bishop or castling. And I think it's because they want to break the pin, but not standard. The pin's not really a big deal. And I'm just going to keep going with my development. Get the light squared bishop out, so play pawn to e3. And here we go, the knight comes forward, double attacking my knight here and attacking my bishop. That's why he wanted to move the queen so that he could move the knight forward. But it's not really good. This is too early to be making all these moves without finishing your development or getting castled. I see what he wants to do. They want to trade knight for bishop though. But I'm going to go queen to c2. That's a developing move where I usually go with my queen and adds another defender here. And they trade knight for bishop. So now they have the bishop pair, I guess. Slight advantage, but this is not the grandmasters, so not a big deal, I don't think. And I'll just bring my knight back now. They played pawn to h and castled. Now they're castled, but they're still not developed on this side. They haven't developed their knight, bishop, or rook, and that's going to be huge. That's the key to this game. And that's why I play h4. I see how underdeveloped they are and how they move their queen up. They only have the queen and the bishop out, and I'm almost completely developed. So I'm just trying to attack the king now. And instead of developing now, they go for c5, thrusting forward with the pawn, trying to break open my center maybe and attack, add some pressure to this knight. But it's just not very sound because they haven't developed, and I decide that trading it off is best here, which it is. And now I play the terrible move, knight to g5, currently threatening checkmate in 1, so they basically have to take here. And the reason I did this was because they're completely undeveloped on the left side here, and the queen is in a weird spot, so the queen can't actually come over to defend like it normally would be able to. So I'm just going to try to bust open this king, and it's, the engine hates it, but it's actually going to work out here because it's a little bit tricky to play for them just because of how underdeveloped they are. And the best move, g6, to prevent me from coming up. And now I just try to go for an all-out attack on the king. So bishop to d3, I could take with the bishop here, and if the pawn takes back, the queen comes in, and this is checkmate. So they have to figure out how to defend against this. And the best move is king to g7, which would actually just be basically winning from here for them. But they decide to move the queen back to defend here. And that's actually going to be a big mistake. Still winning, but it's starting to turn around. And I bring the rook up to add another attacker here. And now they play king to g7. But it's not as good as it was before. But still pretty good. They're going to try to get the rook over here. Now that I'm down material, if they start trading and simplifying, that's really bad for me. So I'm starting to feel like I made a bad move at this point, and I'm realizing that my attack is not going to be as good as I thought it might be. But I castle, maybe get my other rook involved, and to free up this knight, because the knight is no longer pinned to the king like it has been the entire game. And that's crucial because now rook to h8 is a big blunder. And I didn't realize it was going to be a blunder until they made the move. And then I saw the brilliant knight captures d5. But that's not what I played. I actually played knight to b5, attacking the queen. But it's still winning because if I take on d5 and the queen takes, now I can play bishop to e4, attacking the queen with the rook and the bishop. And when the queen moves out of the way, best square is e6. Now I take the rook. And after they take back, we come down here, check with the rook, and we're attacking the bishop twice. King has to go to g7, and then we take the bishop. And now they're up +1, but you're absolutely crushing the position because this knight is pinned to the rook. They can't develop. Two of their pieces are just useless here. All three of your pieces are involved in the game, and pretty soon you're going to be up in material. So, but instead of that, I played knight to b5, and this is still winning, attacking the queen now, and they're trying to trade queens off. Like I said, if they simplify, they're up material, and they can just easily win, but not anymore because of their lack of development. Huge move, knight to c7, and after we trade queens, their rook is trapped. There's no way to stop me from taking this rook. They finally develop their bishop, but I'm just going to trade the rooks off because after I take their rook, now I'm plus 3 in material, and now I'm the one that wants to simplify, trade pieces, and win the game. So here we go. My knight is kind of stuck in this corner for now, but they can't really take it. And I'm going to double up on this pawn in the middle. They can't add any more defenders right now, so they're going to have to try to counterattack. And bishop to e7 attacks my pawn on g5, and I'll defend it with f4. And now the bishop goes to attack my e3 pawn. My king moves up to defend it, but now they hit me with some checks. And this is where it gets a little bit tricky because I want to defend this pawn with my king so that my rook and my bishop can attack here. But I can't go here because it's blocked by the bishop, and I can't go here because of this fork or x-ray, whatever it's called. I would lose my rook to the bishop, which I don't know, might be still winning. It's like drawn, but plus one for me, basically. So I have to go back to c2, and now the bishop comes and checks me, and I go back to c1, where I should have gone in the first place. And now we'll just defend the pawn with the rook instead. And here the knight comes up, and I like this move, because now I can bring my king up, and the bishop can't check me here. Now I'm defending this with the king, and getting ready to push here. Knight comes up, but now there's no one defending this pawn. And even though the knight's attacking my rook, I have this check. And now, king to g7, and we take the pawn now, giving me huge control in the center here. And after the knight takes on b2, it's basically game over. After e4, attacking the bishop here, which has to go back. And now I realize that this knight cannot really get out. It's kind of trapped. So I go to bishop to b3 to block the only escape square, currently defended by this bishop though. And after a couple more moves, we're just going to win the game. Because now the knight can come to c7 to attack this bishop, which needs to be defending this square so that the knight can escape. And after the bishop goes back, we just trade it off. And now the knight is trapped. Bring the king over to c2. Knight is trapped. Bishop tries to defend it. Use the rook to add another attacker. And they resigned right here. They can try to go for some pawns, but it's just going to be a king, or it's going to be a rook and a bishop versus a bishop. It's going to be an easy end game here for me. They won't be able to stop me from promoting, and I win the game. And that was a 1650 opponent, which is feels like a high-rated opponent for me, but I've been gaining a lot of rating recently. My rating has gone up recently, 116 points in the last 30 days. So I stopped playing for probably 2 or 3 months. Been playing a lot of poker, and when I got back to playing, I just gained all these points. I just went from high 1500s to high 1600s, gained about 100 points here. Still going, crushing the 1800 rated opponents, 1600, 1700, 1800 rated opponents. So if you guys want to see more of these commentary games, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button so I know. Maybe leave a comment saying you want more of these, because I got a lot more games here that I want to commentate for you guys. I haven't been streaming, but I can maybe talk through some games, do some commentaries on some of these good wins that I got. So let me know if you want to see more of these, and I'll do more of them. Thanks for watching. See you on the next time with the Bobby Bo Show. Have an excellent rest of your day.